A little scan across the valley here. But there in the sunlight, on the other side, is the Palestinian West Bank. I'll just try and zoom in, because what we're looking at there is Jericho. Here we are, picking eggplants. And although these eggplants have come almost right through summer, they're still going as we plant the winter crops. As we cool down, we've got a bit of calmer weather now. Tiniest bit of rain last night, a little bit of extra cloud. As it cools down, the wicking beds just take off on the roof. Our climbing spinach is going crazy. It's been a great crop here. Two perennial spinaches have been working for us. The Ceylon spinach, and we've particularly got the red stem Ceylon spinach. And come right through summer is a Brazil spinach, actually from the Amazon. But here it is in the Dead Sea Valley, an extremely dry landscape, and it's totally perennialized. I think this one's about 3 years old now. It's an Antheria sisu, growing in a landscape like this, just because we're using wicking beds. I'm watering down below the soil in a gravel tank that sits underneath the planting bed. The most efficient watering system in the world, and that more or less proves it. One of the cheapest ways you can make your own wicking beds is to purchase a bulk liquid container secondhand. So you're recycling the material. Now these containers are available everywhere. You need an angle grinder, and you can cut through both the plastic and the frame at the same time, giving you two wicking beds. They're just the right size, and you have a good strong support frame. Now, you need to set this up with an input of water from the top through pipes, which soak in at the bottom through gravel. This is simple. We just get a plumbing pipe and we can either drill it or we can cut it with an angle grinder. Then all we need is a basic plumbing fitting. So a right angle fitting and then a filler pipe, which is vertical with no slots in it. We can cover the end of the pipe with a shade cloth, because all we need is water to soak in through the gravel at the bottom. If this soakage pipe goes from corner to corner, it's covering the whole bottom of the wicking bed, and that's enough to fill and soak all the way across. Next, you need to half fill your wicking bed with 10 mil gravel on top of your soak pipe. Level out that gravel so it's nice and even, and then put in a membrane that'll separate the next layer, which is your good quality soil. That can be a good sheet, usually doubled over shade cloth does it fine. So we don't quite fill it with soil. After you've leveled your soil, you leave enough for a good layer of high quality compost. You level that out, and then a layer of mulch. So you're literally creating a garden over a gravel tank that soaks your water up with capillary action. Once you have the whole system mulched, you've got your good quality compost, you've got your good thick layer of mulch on top, it'll really hold a lot of water. Next, we bore a hole in the side of the container just above the gravel at the bottom of the soil. We insert an irrigation grommet, which is a watertight grommet that fits a small irrigation right angle fitting. That gives you a bit of a swivel pipe where you can adjust the depth of water. This allows us to overflow and swivel that irrigation fitting up and down a little bit to change the level. Once we see that overflowing, we know the gravel at the bottom is full and the capillary action is soaking the soil from underneath. We can water a little bit on top, plant our vegetables, and we're off and growing. Here we have a couple of the ladies from the internship, heavily stacking the vegetables in wicking beds, yeah? I mean, have you ever stacked vegetables so close?
Traditionally, no.
This one's actually got a worm farm induction tube, which is one of our experiments here. We've got a worm farm down the water pipe, so we've got a bigger water pipe on this one. And so we're actually watering through a worm farm. So all the grey water from the bottom kitchen and the top kitchen. So we've got a double deck of kitchen sink feed into this little reed bed. you're transplanting the reeds from that corner more evenly across the bed, yeah?
Yeah, we're evening the plants because all the plants are concentrated here, so we're trying to even out.
And as soon as we see water at the surface, we usually drain it, but right now, keeping it a little bit flooded, it's going to make it easy to do the transplant. I'll just show you the exit point of this very simple reed bed. Just over here, it exits right next to the nursery. So it comes out here, and right now, it's coming, let's follow this hose. It's going down here.
My sweet pepper.
And it's been going out here into this date palm. And I'm right at the bottom of the site. I'm on the bottom western boundary, which we need to keep very shaded because it helps shade the western sun from our main crop garden. The garden group are on the bottom bed. You can see the amount of compost we've put on the ground. We've stacked it pretty thick. But just because we're on contour, we've got kind of a bottom bed that bows a little bit thin at each end.
Yeah,
a little bit wide in the middle because we're on contour. But so that ready. Compost is going to get covered by mulch and then planted out, and off it goes. So this is shade gardening of diversity and extended season in dryland systems. Corn producing quite well. It's actually surprised me. So it's the end of summer corn. And then we swing around the lower western boundary from the lowest point up to the side boundary chicken tractor. And this is where the engine of fertility is. And they're turning the top one down to the second one. I'm just looking at our temperature here, 64. I mean, they say 65 is perfect, but this is the end of the run. 1 week after this, it's more or less ready. This one's 2 weeks away. This one's 3 weeks. So if we get this right,
every week. That's what we've been doing so far.
Yeah.
Just take one out every week.
A cubic meter does a lot of fertility for you. It'll easily fertilize this 3,000 square meter site. Have we got the sprinklers running yet?
There's a hole in the line, so it's not working for
us. There's a leak. I see someone's tuned the leak up into the swale there. Every time there's a leak and we can't repair it quickly on this site, someone just turns water sideways and lets it flow down into one of the contour harvesting swales. So we've got our leak going out on contour. We'll be fixing that soon. Eric here is just distributing some of the accumulated compost and manures, particularly aiming at citrus, which need a bit of help here.
Just some papaya too.
And papayas, yeah. Citrus like a little bit acid. Papayas like it a little bit more tropical and moist. We'll give them a little bit more compost and a little bit more old manure. And then we're gonna mulch the chop and drop species on top of them, which are mostly leucaena. I was going to boost up a little bit of natural fertility here now the temperatures are dropping. And it's got time to be taken up by the soil and transferred to the trees as nutrient. Transferring the forest growth into soil life. Stage by stage, the little desert project can become more and more green, more and more shady, more and more productive every year.